Ringin gökyüzünde, her opponent, the boxer in the blue corner, representing Ireland, Kitty Taylor.
And much like in London at the 2012 Olympic Games, it is the two women who broke through the glass ceiling to put women's boxing on the map globally, Nicola Adams and Kitty Taylor, who are the standout performers so far in the women's boxing in this tournament. Adams has done it again with a gold. Now can Kitty do it again? The women's lightweight final, as Kitty Taylor bids for her 18th major title. Chastened perhaps by the experience, almost succumbing to a first defeat in what, more than 4 years, Kitty in that semi-final. I thought she actually started well against Alexevna. But the question is how much Mossely's confidence has been boosted by her brilliant performance in her semi-final. Kitty takes centre ring away from her. Looking to demonstrate that she's got the superior power, I think. Mossely is a talented boxer, but I'm not quite certain she's fought too many opponents as sturdy as Kitty in this lightweight division at 60 kilograms. Kitty trying to lay it on her early on. It's 2 minute rounds, incidentally, four of them. Mossley's reach is good and she's had no problem finding the target with that jab. Good work from her, the French girl. Certainly, she looks transformed to me by the confidence of a few results in a big tournament. Would never have backed her at the start of this to get to the final, but she's looking pretty sharp here early on. Kitty knows this could be hard again, just as the semi-final was. By no means having it all her own way. Like every other competitor in the women's boxing, Mossely speaking of her respect and admiration for Kitty Taylor, but it counts for naught at this moment. And she's doing her very best to keep the pressure on right through to the last few seconds of this opening round. Kitty lost the opener in the semi-final against Alexevna, and that really was the root of all the problems. Words from her dad, Pete. Looking composed enough, but she will know that it was all uphill in the semi-final once she had lost the opening round. No argument that Mossely made a good start. How do the judges view this? They're split. Katie's edged it. Certainly better than it was yesterday. So let's see if Kitty Taylor can consolidate now in a narrow lead here early on. Mossely again claiming centre ring, working off that orthodox jab. Kitty looking to make her power pay underneath. Mariusz Gorny from Poland, the referee. It's a test of stamina, conditioning of course, mental resolve, fighting day after day in big tournaments. Kitty felt all her experience got her over the line in the semi-final. She's been doing this for so long. All brand new and mostly fresh, full of confidence. Not quite with the right hand for Kitty Taylor. Stop. Mossely very keen to try to stand her ground. It looks like the French have got a very well-worked-out game plan here, that they're going to try to deny Kitty Taylor some of her natural strengths. It's only reasonable, from their point of view, to do that, encouraging Mossely to stand her ground and not give ground away. Katie's got to earn her authority here. Mossely continuing to set the pace, and Katie looking to demonstrate that she's got the better weight of punch. Last 20 of the second round. Billy Walsh checking that stopwatch. Can Katie finish with a flourish here in this second round? Mossely again looking very pleased with her own work, and rightly so. Not sure it's the most accurate round that Katie Taylor's ever produced. Let's see if it's enough for her. It is enough. So nothing for the French girl. And clearly the weight of punch weighing on the minds of the judges here. Good position for Katie Taylor. Much better than it was this time yesterday in the semi-final. Third round will decide it, surely. If she can repeat what she's produced in the second round, there'll surely be no way back for Estelle Mossely. Michael O'Reilly, of course, watching on. The last of the Irish to go into action for a medal in this tournament. The young man from Portlaoise. And of course, they all look up to Katie Taylor so much. She's aware of the responsibility. She lives up to it. She relishes it. And she, time and again, provides the inspiration for all of her teammates. Leave aside the nation at home. What a wonderful double it could be for Ireland today. Mossely again trying to close the range. Perhaps you could argue that when she does start to come in, she doesn't quite fire quickly enough. A little bit of attention for the ponytail, I believe. Gives both a breather. Mossely claiming ground, but not claiming points with it. The left hook on the way as Katie came forward was a better shot. Right hand round the side by the French girl. That's sharp from Katie. Could argue at her veteran age, almost turning 29 in just a week or two, that it does begin to become the case that she takes a little bit of time to warm up sometimes. Shots are beginning to flow now from Katie Taylor. With all the experience she's got, she always knows where the finish line is, and that was demonstrated yesterday. She knew she had to win the last round big, and she did. And she looks like she's applying that logic to this third round. With a lead already, a good score in the third round would pretty much put her out of sight. Here's hoping. Beautiful. So experienced. The temperament of a proven champion. Even if there might be a little memo to the hairdresser. That should fix it. Not easy being a girl. On we go. Last 10 seconds in the third round. Excellent left by Katie Taylor. Second time as well. Pouring it on here. You just knew she'd do this. She knows she's got a clock inside her head. She knows when it's time to impress the judges, and she looked to finish strong in that round. It's a great left hook, wasn't it? And I think it's great, man or women, to see the way she's prepared to exchange. She's in a winning lead here. She's three clear with one to go. She's poured it on in rounds two and three. been a very valiant effort from Estelle Mossely. Youngster on the way up, but she knew she could get a schooling today from the great Katie Taylor, and it's beginning to look like that is the case. The last 2 minutes of this championship in the women's lightweight, and Katie Taylor is all set to be crowned queen once more. All she's got to do is keep it going. Wait for the openings to arrive in this fourth round. No need to rush it. She'll know that better than anybody. The range will not help Mossely now. Katie can work at her own pace. And that's what she's doing. Staying on the outside. She's in command. It's up to Estelle Mossely to change the plot. I don't quite think, at this stage in her career, she's got what it takes to do it. It's the last minute now. Decent left from Mossely, but Katie was almost in a case there where she saw it coming. She'd almost got her guard up. Took most of the sting out of it, and she's taken the sting out of the best that Estelle Mossely's been able to produce. That's beautiful from Taylor. And again, a lovely right counter, uppercut. The shots that have counted have come from Katie Taylor. More power, and just that ability to stop Mossely in her tracks. And altogether, it's less stressful than it was in the semi-final, because Katie Taylor is surely cruising over the line to yet another gold medal here for Ireland. The supreme champion in women's boxing and one of Ireland's greatest ever athletes has surely done it again here in Baku. And she bossed the final, quite unlike the scare she had in the semi. She knows it, everybody knows it. It's a great effort from Estelle Mossely. She's not quite in the top draw in the women's lightweight division at this time, but she may well get there. The girl that Taylor fought yesterday, Alef Sevna, who knows, they might meet again in the Olympic final, right at the top of the rankings. The thumbs up from Katie Taylor. She knows she's done it.
Final galibi ve Baku 2015 Avrupa Oyunlarının şampiyonu. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the final in women's 57-60 kilogram lightweight category and the European Games champion by unanimous decision, in blue corner, representing Ireland, Katie Taylor.
The run goes on for one of the all-time great Irish athletes. Reigning Olympic champion and now the inaugural European Games gold medalist. And even the president of Azerbaijan is in the fan club as he embraces Pat Hickey. It's a great day for the Irish. And what a start with Michael O'Reilly still to come. Katie Taylor has done it to make Ireland again stand so tall in international boxing terms. Join us again in just a few minutes.